As we said, we opened it up for calls on this MLB situation.
And plenty of people want to jump in, Chris.
Yep, 877-99 on Fox. All right, let's open it up, Rob.
Let's do it. Derek in Texas, you're on the Odd Couple Fox Sports Radio. What you got, Derek?
Hey, what's up, fellas? How y'all doing?
Great, hey, man. How are you?
I'm doing pretty good. Enjoy y'all's show. I listen to it all the way from work to home, every 46 miles of it.
Appreciate
Thank
that.
You, man. Thank you.
Hey, but fellas, let's talk about everybody is talking Astros. Hey, what about Boston? They coach got a job for doing what he did with the Astros and then won another championship doing it with Boston.
I said that to Chris. I said, we don't know yet because the other shoe hasn't dropped.
But if instead of taking a title, hey, let's just cancel the Astros season and Boston season and see what it does for baseball.
Nah, you can't do that.
You don't want to punish the whole sport.
My point exactly. But we're not going back to take the rings from the Oakland Athletics when McGuire and Conseco was shooting up, are we?
Well, I think this is different. This was organizational all the way down.
See, Derek, so I hear your point, but I'm with Chris. Organizational is different. That's where you set up a cheating culture. That's not like one or two players. That means even if you say Conseco and McGuire were doing it, that means that there could have been 23 other players not doing it. So you're going to punish all of them?
I mean, it's totally different.
It'd
be the equivalent of like if the A's basically had their own little store.
And everybody was getting shot up. Right.
They're handing it out to guys. Yeah. You know, take this, take that, you know.
That would be totally different.
Right, right.
All right, let's go to Tony in D.C. You're on the Odd Couple Fox Sports Radio. What's up, Tony?
Hey, fellas, what's going on? Always nice to talk to you guys.
Thank you.
I think the commissioner of baseball really dropped the ball here. You know, in each sport, each commissioner, I think, is pretty much, if they're a commissioner long enough, they're going to get hit with a controversy. Stern with the malice at the palace, Goodell with the domestic abuse thing. And that's your legacy, pretty much. He should have at least been like, you know what, I'm going to take on the players' union. Whatever happens, happens. You don't leave any stones unturned. And he didn't, you know, then to say, like Chris said earlier, a piece of metal, you know, this guy, I think he's in over his head. And that's all I have to say. But Rob, my Cowboys are going 12-4. I want my wings, brother.
All right, we're going to get on that football season for sure, Tony. Appreciate it.
When you say a piece of metal, Rob, it doesn't sound good.
The
appearance that you're in over your head. Like, you don't understand the gravity.
No, I agree.
Of your position or the situation. I hate to say it that way.
But that piece of metal is bigger than that. Kevin, we're going to squeeze one more in. Kevin in Missouri, you're on the Odd Couple Fox Sports Radio. What's up, Kev?
Hey, guys. Love the show. Listen all the time.
Thank you, bud.
Just love it. Love listening. Keeps me occupied. Keeps me out of trouble. Hey, I just want to say, my dad played baseball. He was quite the baseball player back in the day, you know, back in the 40s and 50s. And he played a farm team called the Red Legs years ago, before it was the Red Sox. But back then, they had morals. And I'm just telling you, just from knowing my dad and why he was alive and everything, that if they would have gave that to him and he would have even known he was a part of that, he would have handed the ring back and said, I want nothing to do with this.
Well, there were some. Who was the player?
It was a minor leaguer who came up.
Yes.
And they were trying to show him what they had in place or whatever. And he was basically like, don't show me. I'm not interested. I don't want to know. I'm not.
And I'm sure there were a few other guys like that. Correa said Altuve was that. I'm not so sure about that.
Yeah, I don't know. I heard that too, Chris. And that one did not work for me.
Right, right. So, but I'm sure.
Yeah, he had the buzzer attached to his skin. He didn't need the crash can.
Right. Come on. All right. He's a World Series champion, a three-time MLB All-Star, and really was a bit iconic during his playing days. Cecil Fielder. Cecil, welcome to the iCon.
Cess, what's up?
What's up, Rob Parker? What's happening? What's happening?
How you doing?
I can't complain. Life is good.
Good, good. Well, let's get right to it. Baseball's in the news, unfortunately, for all the wrong reasons. What's your take on this whole cheating scandal with the Houston Astros?
Well, it is what it is. I mean, they cheated. They did what they said they did. You just don't know how long it's been. Was it just 2017 and 18, or was it 19 too? So, you know, it's a mess. I think the players can handle it a lot better than, you know, doing it in the media. I mean, each team knows how to handle their business. I mean, they've been doing it for years, and I think it would be better served if everybody just kind of kept quiet and let each team handle the Astros like they want to, you know?
Cecil, that's the thing that's so shocking, and, you know, we know how strong the union is. I've never seen player against player like I've seen in this thing. I've never seen it, and I mean, people are out ripping each other, ripping these players. Is it because, you know, people are always looking for an advantage, Seth, but is this like the ultimate crossing the line and having organizational cheating? Is that why players are so mad about this?
Rob, you know, this is a different group of folks we're dealing with. I mean, this is a different era. These kids have never had to go through a strike, never had to, you know, come together and stick together and make it happen. So these kids have just really, you know, been soldiering on their own for so long. And I just think, you know, they just don't know any better. They don't have a feeling of what the union has been all about for so many years. So I think, again, if we were really thinking about doing this the right way, everybody would kind of keep quiet and just let teams deal with the Astros like they need to be dealt with, because they definitely need to be dealt with, but you do it in a different way.
So obviously you're talking about on the field, you know,
police the game themselves,
been about,
right?
Yeah, the players policing it, throwing at
exactly,
them, stuff like that.
Exactly,
but what about
exactly.
Do you think, what about vacating the title? Do you think that should have been in play? So you just think
that.
Just handling it
you
on the field is all that needs to be done?
Well, you know what? Yeah, because, you know, at the end of the day, that's the only thing that's, I mean, you can tell, say, the commissioner, I wouldn't have never gave the kids, all these kids, immunity. I'd have made them testify and made sure that they told the truth, but I wouldn't have gave them immunity. And that's really the only way that this thing would have really calmed itself down, if the commissioner would have stood up and said, hey, no, ain't nobody getting immunity. If you cheated, I want to know about it, what you did. No, I had a tattoo, blah, 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 none of that. Give me the real truth and tell me what happened. Did you wear a buzzer? If you did wear a buzzer, I want to know about it. And if you did, I got to get you. Because, okay, if you're going to get Pete Rose and keep Pete Rose out of the game for 30, 40 years and not be able to get into the Hall of Fame because he cheated, what are you going to do about this group?
Well, that's a big question, and that'll probably play out down the road. Now, you just talked about the buzzer and all that, but Seth, you played a long time. You watch baseball. The reaction to by Altuve after you hit off walk off game winning home run in the bottom of the ninth, two outs against Aroldis Chapman, and he was concerned about his jersey. When you see that, what is that? Does that tell you anything?
Just red flags just fly up. You
right,
know, everything is suspect at that point. I mean, you know, the different things that they've said about him not wanting his jersey turned off from his wife, you know, not, you know, I mean, it's just stupid.
Right.
I mean, it's just stupid. It's just like, man up, man. Hey, apologize and mean it. And I don't think he's apologizing really meant it. He's just trying to get this thing to go away, and it's never going away. It's not going away.
Cecil, there are some people saying this is worse than the PED steroid scandal. Is that your feeling? What do you think about it?
Well, I think this is definitely worse than that, and I think it's definitely worse than what Pete Rose did. You know, I think this is the worst thing that's happened in the game in 50 years. I mean, this is the worst.
Yeah, I mean, wow. I think people are starting to feel that way, especially because it was the organization, like, signing off on it. And now here's the other shoe to drop. With the Red Sox, I mean, we're not done with this. This could engulf the whole baseball season, because the Red Sox haven't been given clearance that they didn't do anything. We don't know what's going to happen there.
Well, you don't know how many teams have been doing this, because all the technical things that they need are right there in the dugout.
Right.
I mean, this ain't like rocket science. I mean, everybody got TVs and cameras and everything. I mean, so you don't know how far this thing is going to go. And at what end is it going to end?
But let me ask you, do you think you would have taken part? I mean, you are a great home run hitter and all that. Would you, if that was presented,
that
would
never
it would tip
been,
you?
That never would have been a present in our club. I said, you know, Sparky wasn't going for
right.
Stuff like
I don't believe it. I totally agree with that. I just don't believe. And that's why A.J. Hinch saying that he didn't do anything. I don't even know how that got past him.
Well, you know, and this is another part of this. They trying to throw this all on Carlos Beltran, and he ain't even playing no more.
Right. That's probably why they doing it.
Right, because he ain't. Right.
Yeah, exactly. Okay. You guys hit it right on the head. Since he ain't playing no more and he ain't there, let's throw the baggage on him and try to get rid of it. Yeah, you're right.
World Series champion Cecil Fielder joining the Odd Couple. Cecil, I've heard people, I totally disagree with this take, but I've heard some people try to say, well, you know, it's not that big of an advantage. You still got to hit the ball.
Man,
can you
let
explain?
Me tell you something.
Let
me tell you something right now. You tell all your people what I just said. You tell me what's coming every pitch. Let me know what's coming. And somebody going to get hurt. I'm going
to
tell you that right now.
Is right. There's no way coming, that doesn't help you.
Right.
Oh, my God. If I know what's coming, you guys got to tell your folks. Come on, man, y'all. That's almost like saying, okay, taking steroids don't help my strength. You know, it's not a big factor. Come on, guys.
And especially the if you look at Chapman after he gives up the home run to Altuve, he just staring like, wow.
They knew.
Am I
they
right?
Knew they, were they knew though. They knew that everybody had been complaining about that.
The Yankees were complaining too during the playoffs.
Yes, they were complaining about it. I mean, we felt. And listen, I'm gonna tell you another thing, Rob. There's no way I'm sitting on a slider when a man throw 105.
Right. That's the point. Is like, how are you sitting on a slider? This guy throws as hard as anybody, and he was ready for it, Seth, right. And took it out the park.
And another thing, Rob, he wasn't out front. He wasn't, you know, tricked, nothing. He was on it.
Yep, that's true.
Yep,
that's what Mike Trout said. You know, he said, you could just tell by their at bats,
right?
You know,
yeah. I mean, they were on it. They were on it. And you know, bless his heart, the shortstop, you know, trying to defend his boy. I understand, but you know, it's kind of hard.
Right, Correa, right, trying to say that Altuve of all people, he wasn't involved in it, dude. Nobody can buy that or believe it. I mean, that's
Altuve already apologizing for it. So how can you say he wasn't involved
right,
in it?
Right.
Hey, Seth. Last thing, I think, and I told Chris this. I think the Astro fans will boo them on opening day, even their own fans, because they've stripped from the fans their one moment, their championship that now other fans won't even legitimize or you know what I mean, acknowledge. You think there's a chance of that?
I don't know if they fans going to boo them, but every ballpark they go to around the league, they're going to get definitely booed.
Right. Yeah, I don't think their fans will. I think they might even try to support them.
And I've seen a stat before I go. I've seen a stat, Rob, that Altuve hit almost 400 at home and 143 on the road.
Yep. That was a number.
Yeah.
That's crazy.
I thought it might even been better than 400.
Yeah. It was at least 400. I know. It was unbelievable. And on the road, he couldn't hit himself out of a wet paper bag, which is crazy. And now, just to look at that player, I'll never look at him the same way. I can't.
No, he's not. He ruined his credibility. His credibility is gone. And you know the problem is though that they have, Rob, with the Players Association. You got your guys like Trout and the big boys speaking up on it. And I think the commissioner whiffed at it. He should have demanded penalties for cheating and not gave everybody immunity. I mean, I think that was just a way out for him to say, hey, you know, we're going to nip this in the bud right away. I'm going to give everybody immunity. But it ain't going away.
It ain't going away. No doubt about it. Hey, one of the best guys I ever covered, both in Detroit and New York, Cecil Fielder, joining us on the Odd Couple, man. Cecil, we appreciate you.